the New York Rangers are in fact a rolling. And this February, Kevin Shattenkirk will hold his second annual Jam Cancer in the Can event on February 9th, 2019. And he joins us now via FaceTime. Kevin, we talked to you about this event last year. In the event, you actually get to the championship, you lose. So I need to know how you're heading into this event. Have you been working on your game? What is? We'll get to the Ranger stuff. But first, most importantly, what's your mindset as you look to get back to the championship?
Yeah, I think there's no way I can lose 2 years in a row. So I got to make sure I was practiced this summer, made sure that my Frisbee skills are on point and my Can Jam game is ready to go.
Well, we got full confidence that you will return to glory when the time comes. And just give us a little background on the event and why this was something that you were drawn to.
Well, I think last year was a good chance to just kind of kickstart it and make sure that people realize what it is. And I think this year that now that we have the footage, people understand what's going on. It's hopefully something that we can grow. And really, it's just a way for me to give back to the community I grew up in and just help out in any way that I can. And it's a fun way for fans to come out and just hang out with my teammates and really just have a good, casual, fun day.
Well, Shatty, I know you like to give it to guys in the locker room. Who was the worst player on the team that you saw that can't even throw a Frisbee?
Bucci, hands down. Pavel Buchnevich was awful. But, maybe he took it back to Russia and introduced it to the boys back home.
Hopefully he was practicing his skills as well as he gets ready for the second one. We had Anders Lee on the show a couple of weeks ago. He held a Cancer Jam event as well. When are we going to see the Rangers versus the Islanders form of this event?
You know, it's something that we even talked about last year, just maybe doing like a little promo thing for it. But I think eventually we might be able to mesh the two. Anders obviously is the one who kickstarted this, and they've done a great job with it in Long Island, and we're trying to grow it in Westchester. So maybe down the line here we can get some sort of competition going, and I can take Anders down.
Well, you get a chance to do that tomorrow night. I guess the Rangers and Islanders get to meet again. The Islanders seem to have had the Rangers number, particularly in Brooklyn. I'm sure you guys would be anxious to turn that around on Wednesday night. But you guys have been great, 8-1-1 in your last 10. Why has this group of young Rangers, this supposedly rebuilding, retooling group, been so doggone good?
Well, I think we're finally buying into the system. You know, I think the early stages were a chance for us to just grow and learn and you know, new coaches, new players. But really, we're starting to play just smart hockey. I think we're learning how to manage games when we have leads. And really, everyone's just working hard. It's been fun around the locker room, obviously, when you're winning games. But everyone's chipping in and everyone's playing a part. And that's important.
Well, you mentioned new coaches, and you have the best-looking coach in the NHL, David Quinn, who you also coached you at BU, where I played. Not a big deal. I'm curious, what's Quinny been like? I mean, he's just such a detailed guy. I didn't know what it's been like playing for him at the NHL level.
You know, he's been just that, and I think that was an adjustment for everyone. Having a head coach who takes you aside and works with you on things like having good stick position, making sure that you're staying in the right position at the net, picking up sticks. You know, I think those are things that mostly assistant coaches deal with, but Quinny really, really goes, you know, in full depth with you. And it's been refreshing, even as an older guy, to kind of get those good habits back into my game. And something that I remember at BU, him harping on, and nothing's really changed in that instance. But, you know, it's good to have him obviously behind us and staying on top of us.
You know, you mentioned the coach. You went through a little bit of adversity early in this season. He sat you down for a game. What was, you know, we speculate here about how that plays out. You lived it. Was there a lot of give and take back and forth, a conversation about why this was the case and what was to be expected moving forward?
Yeah, I'm fortunate to have a good relationship, obviously, with Quinny, and the lines of communication were completely wide open. He expected a lot more of me, but also knew that, you know, I was coming back from a major injury, hadn't played a lot. So he gave me the chance to sit out, kind of, you know, gave me a kick in the butt a little bit. But at the same time, it allowed me to watch the game and realize maybe what I wasn't doing and how hard I wasn't playing in certain areas. And just getting the skating back, getting the timing of the game back were all little things that were harder than I expected. But I feel like I'm really going now and trusting my skating and playing well.
It's crazy how far a fresh perspective can go with a whole team, let alone just one person. Hey, before we let you go, you and Witt obviously know each other pretty well based on the pre-interview conversation I overheard you guys having.
Yeah.
Not that I was eavesdropping, but what can you tell us about Witt? Anything?
Yeah, come on, Chatty. Fill him in.
Let's see. He's definitely the best player to ever wear number 3 at BU.
All right.
Me second, of course.
Yeah. Right. 1-2.
He's a heck of a golfer, obviously. Mm-hmm. And he unfortunately got cut from the St. Louis Blues because Alex Pietrangelo came back. So he's the only guy.
Thanks a lot, Petro.
The only guy that we really missed that year was Witt, but yeah, Petro came back and got his money.
I was the locker room jester in training camp, just trying to make Shaddy laugh as he just chucked nasty sauce all around the ice. So I appreciate you taking me in.
Best 2 weeks of my pro career.
I love it. Well, listen, thanks for chatting with us. The Cancer Jam event is in February. If you want to check it out, you can head to the website. They're looking to get over the $1 million raised mark. So if you want to help out, you can check it out online. Thanks, Kevin.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me.